Here we're going to talk about solving rational equations. So all a rational equation is an equation with rational expressions. Now remember, rational expressions are like fractions, but they can contain polynomials in either the numerator or the denominator. Now I would like you to first, for this video, I'd like you to review finding the LCD of rational expressions. Okay, so that video actually talks about a lot of important strategies that apply in different situations, and especially to solving rational equations. So what we're going to do, just like with solving equations involving fractions, is try to clear the fractions. Now, looking at this, we do that by finding the LCD. So I want to find the least common denominator for all three rational expressions. So that would involve the x, the 2, and the 4. So what's the smallest polynomial or product of polynomials that x, 2, and 4 all go into evenly? That would be 4x. Okay, so 4x, I'm going to write that as 4x over 1. This 4x, this is the LCD. So that's why it's so important to be able to find the LCD, right? Because we're going to be using it for clearing fractions. Now, what's the meaning of the LCD? It's that all the denominators go into it evenly, okay? And it's the smallest quantity with that property. So when I take this 4x, and because it's subtraction here, when I take that 4x and distribute it, right, what's going to happen is first, when I multiply these together, the x's are going to cancel. And when the x's cancel, I'm left with 4 times 3, which is 12. And then minus 4x times 1 half, the 2 goes into the 4 twice, and you're left with 2 times x. Right? That's the whole point of the LCD, is it takes out the x and it takes out the 2. And on the right-hand side, it takes out the 4. 4 goes into 4x, the 4's cancel, and I'm left with just x times the 3. So I have 3x. Okay, now I can solve this equation. Notice how there are no longer rational expressions. I can solve by isolating x. So I'm going to add 2x to both sides. And now I'm looking at, let's see, it's going to be 12 is equal to 5x. And now we're going to divide both sides by 5. And I'm left with x is equal to, well, 12 over 5. Okay, so the one thing about solving rational equations is that sometimes you can find yourself with extraneous solutions. Now, extraneous solutions are numbers that show up here that cause one or more of the original rational expressions to be undefined. Like, for example, looking at this, if x was 0, that would be a problem, right? Because you'd have 0 in the denominator. So you always have to check to make sure that the numbers you end up with here don't cause any of the original expressions to be undefined. 12 over 5 is fine, right? It doesn't cause any of the denominators to be 0, so this would be my solution. And we'll see examples of what I'm referring to right now as extraneous solutions. We'll see those in the next video. Right now we're not seeing examples with those. Let's try another one like this. Okay, let's solve x minus 5 is equal to 14 over x. Okay, so well, once again, I want to clear fractions, so all I do is multiply both sides of the equation by x, right? So I put parentheses around the entire left-hand side and put in x, and same thing with the right-hand side. I'm going to write that as x over 1 because I want to clear the fraction. Now it's subtraction right here, so I have to take the x and distribute. So x times x is x squared, then x times negative 5 is negative 5x. And the right-hand side, the x's simply cancel, and you get 14. Now, this is a quadratic equation, right? The x is raised to the second power, and we know a strategy for that. You want to get 0 on the right-hand side. So I'm going to subtract 14 from both sides. And what am I left with? Well, it's going to be x squared minus 5x minus 14 is equal to 0. Now we want to factor that left-hand side. So it's going to be x minus 7 times x plus 2. And that's equal to 0. Now we set each of these equal to 0. So I get x minus 7 is equal to 0. And the next one is going to be x plus 2 is equal to 0. So finally, x is equal to 7, or x is equal to negative 2. In this case, I have two solutions. Now remember what I mentioned in the earlier video, or in the earlier page, which is that you have to make sure both of these solutions work. That is, you have to plug them in and make sure that the denominators are not 0. And the denominators are not 0 for either 7 or negative 2, right? So these are both indeed solutions. Okay, let's try one more. Let's solve 3 divided by a minus 1 plus 4 equals 10 divided by a minus 1. Now here the denominator is a minus 1, right? So remember, when you're looking for an LCD, the LCD doesn't just have to be a monomial. It can be a binomial. It can have more than one term. So I'm going to multiply both sides of this equation by a minus 1 divided by 1. Okay, and I'm going to write that a minus 1 in parentheses, because I want to multiply this whole, I want to multiply by all of a minus 1. So I need the whole thing in parentheses. And likewise on the right-hand side, it's going to be a minus 1 over 1. Now it's addition, so you take the a minus 1 and you distribute. So do you see here, first of all, how the a minus 1s are going to cancel? That leaves you just 3 over 1, or just 3. Okay, plus, right, so here's what I'm doing. A minus 1 times the first, I just did that. Now a minus 1 times the 4. So it's going to be plus 4 times all of that a minus 1. Okay, and on the right-hand side, the a minus 1s cancel, and I get just 10. Okay, so now I have an equation with no denominators. So it's going to be 3 plus 4a minus 4 equals 10. I distributed the 4, right? So now we have, combining like terms, 4a minus 1 is equal to 10. Add 1 to both sides. So now 4a is equal to 11. And we end up with a is equal to 11 over 4. So that would be my answer. Now notice that, what number causes the denominator to be 0? That would be 1, right? If a was 1, we'd run into trouble, because 1 minus 1 would be 0. And when you have 0 in the denominator, the expression is undefined. But the a here is not 1, right? A is 11 over 4. So 11 over 4 doesn't cause any problems for any of the rational expressions. So this indeed is a solution. Okay, we'll talk about solving rational equations, some more complicated ones, in a future video. Until next time.